So we need to preserve the bees. Bees are not only not the pollinators. We have other things like bats, other kind of bees also. Maybe even birds pollinate the flowers. But bees have a special small tongue which they can go right deep into the smaller flowers also and pollinate it. So by pollination we get extra yield of crop, plus your fruit becomes much better. So there are many advantages of bees. We need to preserve them. Now let me explain how we do beekeeping. Normally if I see a colony somewhere, I'll try to capture it, put it in this box. Each colony has one queen. Only one queen. Rest are worker bees and drone bees. So you'll see in a colony like this, we'll have about 5,000 bees with one queen, one fertile queen. She is a female and she's a fertile female. Worker bees also are females, but they are unfertile. They are not fertile to lay eggs. Fertilized eggs. Then we have drone bees, which are male bees. They only help in mating with the queen once in her lifetime. So once she's virgin, she will go out on the mating flight. She will come down to the box, settle down and start laying eggs. Virgin good queen can lay about 500 to 800 eggs a day. So it's quite a lot. And the cycle of a bee is not too long. It's about 30 to 40 days, a worker bee. A drone is about 2-3 months, but she's only when the queen lays another egg, another virgin queen cell egg, that's the time only she will lay the drone eggs, the male eggs. That is to make two divisions. She wants to make another group of bees, another family, we could say. So she will lay some queen cells, which are longer in size, at the bottom of the hive, and after it is sealed, she will leave away with half of the bees. So once the cell is hatched, it will come out as a virgin queen. The virgin queen will go with some drones out, mate, and come back and make another family. So these are the basics of beekeeping. Now let me explain. The cones normally are of this size. They are hexagon shaped size, six cornered. And they make it in a line. Why they make it that way is because of space. It occupies less number of space, so it is made correct in a line. So in these cells, the queen will lay eggs or will store honey in it. The top layer, which you see here, is always of honey. Then you have a small layer of pollen store. Pollen is a feed for the bees. So the pollen is stored there. And last we have is the eggs, the larva. The larva, pupa, and all the stages of eggs are laid on the bottom of the frame. And if we have queen cells, we'll have it right at the bottom of the frame of the cone. So basically like this, we have eight kinds of frames, sizes of frames in the box. This box is scientifically designed how the bees' habitat is. So we have made two layers. One is the egg chamber layer and one is the super honey chamber layer. Because the pattern of the eggs, I told you all, the egg pattern is downwards, so the chamber down will be only for the queen to lay eggs. The top chamber, which is the top layer where the honey is the top layer. So the top part of the cone is always honey in any cones. Of if you see even Desota bees, whether it's rock bees, whether it's Gloria bees or any kind of bees, same pattern. Except for this stingless Trigona bees who deposit their eggs at one side, pollen one, and the honey one in pots, small circular pots. So you can see the eggs are smaller in size, light yellow in color, and darkish in cells. We have the pollen and the honey cells. So basically we need to get a colony, keep it in your garden or in your balcony or any place which is suitable for the bees, which shouldn't be too hot, neither it should be a warm weather. The temperature should never go above 30-35 in that area. Basically we are talking like not having the direct sun of the midday, that is from 11 to 3 o'clock, which is very hot sun, should not directly fall on the hive. Basically if it gets some sunlight in the morning, evening, it's fine for the box. Secondly, you cannot keep it in a windy place. It has a small opening in the front, where the bees can go out. Like this, we have a gate, queen. This is a queen gate. So the worker bees can go through this, but the queen cannot pass through. So once the queen is, she has been mated, we put the queen gate so that she never goes out, you know, but offhand if she goes out, it may be queenless colony then. So there's only one entrance for the bees. So this is the path where the bees will go out and come in. Similar to this, we have another breed, which is Apis mellifera, European bees. The boxes are bigger in size, and the bees are suitable only for cold climates normally. So in Kashmir and other parts of cooler places, we have the mellifera bees too. Bigger boxes and European countries too. So if you go to sea, you can do beekeeping very easily. Only this part has to be cleared to see that they have enough space, about 3-4 meters. So they take the flight and they go high up so they don't disturb anyone. Whilst working with the bees, we have a smoker which we use to smoke them before we start the work. That gives a block between the bees and us for the smell which the queen produces, and the bees don't feel that we are the enemy going to attack them. So we smoke them before we do our maintenance work or removing of honey, any kind of work. So we have smaller frames which are of the super. And we have bigger size of frames for the brood, for the eggs. Of course, in this also, we will have the eggs and the honey, slight part of honey for the bees. Now, this honey is like a food for the babies and for their workers, worker bees, and the drones. Whoever are there down working, they will be consuming the honey from the down chamber. Now if you go in the top chamber, we have such small frames. These frames normally are filled with honey. So once they are filled with honey, we will uncap the honey and we'll put it in a side machine, the frames, and with the centrifugal force, the honey will come off. And we can reuse the same cones back for the hive. We do this why? Because if you cut the full cone, destroy the cone, bees take very long time. They need to consume lots of honey to produce the wax. Wax is a secretion from smaller bees which are 10 days old. So if that wax, it needs long time to produce, so we are going to take much longer time to rebuild the cone. So we give them a chance to do it faster. We also use a kinds of sheets which are called foundation sheets, made of pure wax, which helps them to do the cone faster. So basically we have a veil which we can wear when we are doing the beekeeping, and we can wear some gloves, any kind of industrial gloves or plastic gloves, and we can manage it. Of course, if you are very good in your job and if you are very gentle with the bees won't sting you even if you do it barehand. So these are the basics of beekeeping. Any questions so far? I got enough of time, more? Yes? Tell me. No, this honey which they make, once the cone is sealed completely, it is pure honey. So it is not too sticky, it's not too, but you need to use a bigger, broader jar to put it, not a narrow bottle, because it's quite thick. Normal real honey is thicker in the texture. Anyone else with any questions? Now let me explain to you this beekeeping. I have been promoting it. Yes, tell me. Honey comes according to the type of flower the bees go on. So if it is a lighter, like a mango, you'll have a light yellow in color. If it's like a jambul, it will be darker in color. Certain flowers have a darker nectar in it. So it depends on what kind of nectar they collect, the color of the honey. Yes. Normally, generally, it is from light yellow to dark brown in color, honey. Now we have beekeeping. I have been promoting it for a couple of years. I do my sessions for the government, the zonal office, agriculture, the Khadi board and the Khadi commission, then the Central Beekeeping Institute in India, which we have, Biodiversity Board, and the Atma, the in Goa. Also the KVK, the Central Agriculture Institute in Goa. So we have a scheme for people who live in Goa. The scheme gives you normally at the moment we have a scheme of 80% subsidy. You only pay 20% for the B box. B box, maybe they'll give a B box, a B box stand, a whale, a smoker, and a hive tool. So basically, if you apply with the agriculture department, the zonal office of yours, or you apply to the Khadi board, they will provide you training, a short-term training program, which has a theory and which will have a practical session. And after the boxes are given, you will have to handle it by yourself. You have to learn how to handle it by yourself. To my opinion, beekeeping is not so easy, not so difficult. Let me put it in simple words. But if you learn the technique properly, you are the master of it. So generally, a box like this costs about 6,000 rupees with the colony bees. The extractor will cost you about 3,000 rupees. We provide you the training, whatever it is, how to do it. Of course, if you are caught up in any tight situation and you don't know what to do, you can always call me. I'll be there to guide you. Yes? How much honey does the bee? Yes. Means how much honey do you get? Or okay. Now the honey depends according to where your colony is situated. If you have lots of nectar source and a pollen source, you can get up to 8 to 10 kgs per year from a colony. Yes, yes. But generally, let me put it, on an average, you should get round about at least 3 to 4 kgs in Goa. At the moment, what we get is average. Only if you go in thick forest areas and all, the production is more. It is good to learn beekeeping. And it is normally I also started as a hobby, now it's become my profession. Generally, people are very scared of bees. Let me tell you, a bee won't harm you unless you disturb a bee. A bee will never harm you unless the bee is disturbed. You can go even close to a hive, the bee won't attack you unless you provoke it for some reason. Generally, even in the night time, bees get attracted to light, but they won't harm you. So you no need of going with a bat, swinging a bat around. And if you swing the bat around, the bee will surely sting you. There are 100% chances of stinging you. Just leave the bee to go where it is. If there's any tight situation where the colony is disturbed, maybe on the roadside or anywhere when you're passing by, you just have to lie down on the ground for a few couple of minutes till the bees settle down somewhere, and then get up and continue with your journey. Don't try to run away, they will run after you. They will come after you after you're out of the water. Especially rock bees are dangerous. They keep on following you if they are disturbed. Yes, tell me. What is this? The normally we have we have rainy season, and we have after the rains we have a flowering season. So generally the honey, all what is got in the box, it comes after the rainy season, after the flowering season starts. So we could say from January right up till April, May is the honey season. Yeah, that's the rainy season. Yes, yes. You have to feed them a solution of sugar and water, 1:1. What? Yes, yes. Mix it. No need of pollen, because we have many coconut trees and all around which they can survive on it in Goa. If at all there's any shortage, you can put mixed pollen in the sugar syrup. Yes, yes, yes. I will give you my number. You take down my number and you can, you know, contact me. Or you can contact Savio also if you know him. Savio. Take down my number and we'll give you. Okay. Any questions, backward, back seated people? We have a counter here also, the first stall here, first table, which you can come for any inquiries or anything if you want any details and all. I stay in Pede next to the sports complex, so anyone you can ask, I'm always there. You can come and have a look at my colony. Savio also has colony. Yes? Leave? How long? Yeah. Worker bee normally 30 to 45 days. A queen survives up to 2 to 3 years. And a drone will be about during the mating season for about a month. 2 months, 3 months, they survive. Okay, yes. Yes, the male will die. Male dies when it's... Male is the one who fertilizes with the queen. No, it won't die.
Thank you, Melvin, for that inspiring and enlightening talk. Kokani machine ek monni asa tension tor mo kala te ton an podona so mashatras kyun te kaatche potta deo bare karu Melvin. And Savio also for that enlightening talk.